A dive into the Chesapeake into what turned out to be shallow water left an active young teenager paralyzed and questioning God. Joni Eareckson Tada has used her handicap to minister to thousands the world over through her books, recordings, and speaking. She has become a well-known and accomplished artist whose paintings inspire and encourage because the beauty of her spirit is reflected on the canvas.
What a taste of heaven this has been today for all of us, I know. When we were singing earlier and the Holy Spirit moved us all to rise and stand to our feet, dear Uncle Doug Holden, he'd been sitting next to me and kind of empathizing with my sitting downness. And he turned to me and said, "Honey, I'm sorry, I just gotta stand up." And I said, "Uncle Doug, I know how you feel, because I'm standing up on the inside." And when we were singing earlier, those couple of marvelous tunes about heaven, I was watching beautiful Babby wave her hands in the air so gracefully. And I tried to get mine up, and I can't get them up much higher than this, because my arms are paralyzed. Pretty good shoulders I have, and I can shrug pretty good, but that's about as high up as they get. But isn't it wonderful to know that one day the eyes of the blind will be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped, and those who can't speak will shout for joy, and the lame shall leap like deer. I get so mad sometimes these days at everything that's so politically correct. That beautiful old hymn, "O for a Thousand Tongues," "Hear him, ye deaf, his praise, ye dumb, your loosened tongues employ. Ye blind, behold your Savior come, and leap ye lame for joy." You know, they've taken that out of the hymnals these days. It's just not politically correct to talk about persons with disabilities as being lame, or those who cannot speak as, quote, being dumb. But being disabled in this wheelchair, paralyzed for almost 30 years, I can't wait for the day when those eyes will be opened and all my friends who cannot speak, dumb as though their tongues might be, will be loosed. And the first words they will say, "Thank you, Jesus, for the grace." Father alone will know all about it. Father alone will understand why. Cheer up, my brother, and live in the sunlight. Tempted and tried, we're all made to wonder why it should be thus all the day long, while there are others living around us. Take it up a half step, okay? Farther along we'll know all about it. Farther along we'll understand why. Cheer up, my brothers, and live. Thank you.
everybody in this room, I would dare say there's not a one of us in this room that have not gone through a sickness or a problem and a hurt. And we've had our days that we thought we might as well throw our hands up and quit. Couldn't have been as severe as Johnny's. Surely not. But when we see Jesus coming in glory, when he comes from his home in the sky, Johnny there will join him in that bright city, and we'll understand.